In this lesson, we'll see le plus avec un adverbe. So let's try to see how to play and how to change the intensity of an adverb. So obviously, we'll cover the present tense, we'll cover the passé composé, and then we'll cover the futur proche. Usually, I'm picking these tenses. Well, the first one, obviously, the present is quite important. Passé composé, it's interesting because it's this compound tense of the past that we tend to use a lot. And futur proche, we use it a lot too, but it's also because it's not a real tense, so we use two verbs. So it's when you start to put other things like the negative form and etc. It's always good to cover these three tenses. So that's the reason why. And we'll start, obviously, with the present, avec le présent. So let's have a look at the way it could work and it will work. Je parle doucement. D'accord? Means I speak softly. And then we want to introduce this intensity and we want to work on that. Je parle le plus doucement possible. And you can see that translation will be I speak as softly as possible. D'accord? Le plus. So it will come before your adverb. And it's quite interesting because normally the adverb should come right after the verb. Okay? But to change the intensity, in that case, le plus will come before the adverb. So it's something that you need to remember. Je parle le plus doucement possible. Je la regarde tendrement. I look at her tenderly. It's extremely romantic. Je la regarde le plus tendrement possible. I look at her as tenderly as possible. D'accord? Je la regarde tendrement. Je la regarde le plus tendrement possible. Possible. The same way, remember, le plus will come before your adverb. So let's see now how it will go for the passé composé tense. J'ai marché rapidement. I walked quickly. So same concept here, hein, rapidement, it's an adverb, so basically it's coming right after your verb, j'ai marché. And for the same reason as we had previously, when we want to introduce this le plus, well, it will come before your adverb. J'ai marché, so this doesn't change. Then you put le plus. Keep in mind that I mean, since the beginning of the lesson, you probably noticed that I'm not pronouncing the S in le plus. Hein? So it's quite important. You don't say le plus, hein, but you say le plus. So j'ai marché le plus rapidement possible. D'accord? I walked as fast as I could. J'ai marché le plus rapidement possible. So, j'ai marché rapidement. J'ai marché le plus rapidement possible. Je me suis changé discrètement. I changed my clothes discreetly. I wanted to introduce reflexive verbs because I thought it would be interesting. Remember, the verb is se changer. Hein? Se changer to change your clothes. In French, it's this reflexive concept. And because it's a reflexive verb, when we start to put the passé composé form, remember that it should be conjugated with the verb être. So this is the reason why you've got suis here. And because it's a reflexive verb, so you will have this pronoun me. Hein? Je me suis changé discrètement. D'accord? I changed my clothes discreetly. And when you want to put this le plus, it will not really disrupt a lot the sentence. We will keep the same logic as we had previously. So le plus will come right before your adverb discrètement. Okay, and so, I mean, you can see, je me suis changé, I mean, this doesn't change, le plus discrètement possible. I changed my clothes as discreetly as possible. D'accord? Je me suis changé discrètement, je me suis changé le plus discrètement possible. So let's see now, youpi youpi, le futur proche. So le futur proche, remember, we construct it with aller, that we conjugate in the present form, in that case, je vais. Then we put the second verb in the infinitive, in the basic form, partir. And after that, we'll have our adverb rapidement. I am going to leave quickly. Je vais partir rapidement. D'accord? For the same reason, look, it's not really tricky. Here, we'll put le plus before the adverb. And the rest, I mean, doesn't change. Je vais partir le plus rapidement possible. I am going to leave as quick as possible. D'accord? It should be quickly, maybe, here. Je vais partir le plus rapidement possible. D'accord? Alors, maintenant, we'll see how it will go with a reflexive verb, because I think it's quite interesting for the same reason as we had previously. Je vais m'habiller simplement. I am going to get dressed simply. D'accord? Je vais m'habiller simplement. So for the same reason here, we'll keep the use of aller. Je vais. D'accord? And because s'habiller is a reflexive verb, we need to keep the me. But because you've got right after the sound of a vowel, we'll put this apostrophe. D'accord? And the second verb will keep, will keep this verb in the infinitive form. Je vais m'habiller simplement. Je vais m'habiller simplement. So let's see now if we put le plus. So it will not be really, really drastic. Like usually it just goes before the adverb and the rest doesn't change. Je vais m'habiller le plus simplement possible. I am going to get dressed as simply as possible. D'accord? Je vais m'habiller simplement. Je vais m'habiller le plus simplement possible. Let's play now with the negative form. Because as you know, it's always a nightmare. So we'll start obviously with the present tense. Je ne parle pas doucement. So you can see that, it's a classic. When you put the negative form, it's coming before and after your verb. And then your adverb will come after the second part of the negative form. I don't speak softly. Je ne parle pas doucement. Je ne parle pas le plus doucement possible. So now you've got the key, you see that it won't be tricky. Le plus will be right before the adverb and then we'll keep the negative form before and after the verb. We don't touch that. Je ne parle pas le plus doucement possible. I don't speak as softly as I can. Je ne la regarde pas tendrement. I don't look at her tenderly. That is not nice. Je ne la regarde pas le plus tendrement possible. So it's the same here. You can see that, it's not really difficult. I don't look at her as tenderly as I can. D'accord? You can keep in mind, because this is the thing, when you put a pronoun, like it's the case here, je ne la regarde pas. Remember that the pronoun la will be glued to the verb, so it means that your negative form will be before the pronoun and after the verb. So this is the reason why you have the ne first, then pronoun verb, la regarde. So I wanted to have an example with a pronoun because I think it's important. So, je ne la regarde pas tendrement. Je ne la regarde pas le plus tendrement possible. Let's see the passé composé would be with an accent, it would be better. Je n'ai pas marché rapidement. I didn't walk quickly. Je n'ai pas marché le plus rapidement possible. I didn't walk as fast, as quickly as I could. So keep in mind that the tricky thing normally for the negative form of the passé composé is to put ne before avoir and then pas right after. Okay, then you will put your past participle marcher. Okay, je n'ai pas marché rapidement. But then, as for the lesson, I mean the topic of the lesson, the introduction of le plus, I mean it's simple. You just put le plus and then after that you put your adverb. Je n'ai pas marché le plus rapidement possible. Je ne me suis pas changé discrètement. I didn't change my clothes discreetly. So it will become je ne me suis pas changé le plus discrètement possible. D'accord? The same configuration as we had before, huh? When it comes to the negative form. It's not surprising. You've got ne, then you've got the pronoun me, then you've got your être, and after that pas. And it continues. And when you introduce this le plus, it goes before the adverb. I mean, it's not really tricky here. Let's see for the future proche now. Je ne vais pas partir rapidement. I am not going to leave quickly. It will become je ne vais pas partir le plus rapidement possible. Okay, remember that for all these tenses, there are two tenses like that. So this futur proche and passé proche or passé récent, the negative form will impact the first verb. Hein. Je ne, then you put your go verb, aller, vais, conjugated obviously, and then pas is coming right after. Je ne vais pas partir rapidement. For the rest, je ne vais pas partir le plus rapidement possible. It's simple. Hein. Je ne vais pas m'habiller simplement. I'm not going to get dressed up simply. And then, je ne vais pas m'habiller le plus simplement possible. I'm not going to dress as simply as I can. Okay? So you can see that in these cases, it's just the same. I mean, it's not that tricky. I mean, same thing here. Ne and pas will impact the first verb. Vais, je ne vais pas. And the rest continues. M'habiller le plus. And then your adverb. Voilà, j'espère que c'était clair.